Welcome to the channel The Substitute, and we are here for the match review of last night's match between Tottenham Hotspur and West Ham United. So it was a very great match, London Derby at its best, and it was at Tottenham Hotspur's ground. And first of all, we will look at the lineups that both the team's managers have put in for the match. We will look at Tottenham Hotspur lineup. Hugo Lloris starting in the goalpost, Jorge, Sanchez, Alderweireld, Reguilón, Soko, Hojbjerg and Ndombele in the midfield, Steven Bergwijn, Harry Kane and Son in the attacking options. Gareth Bale is not starting, he's on the bench as expected from the Jose Mourinho. And now we will look at the lineup of West Ham United. Fabianski started in the goalpost, Kofal Mesuaki in the wingbacks, Valbuena, Ogbonna and Creswell in the defence. Jared Bowen and Pablo Fornals on the wings, Susik Rice in the center of midfield and Antonio in the forward position. Surprisingly, there was no Sebastian Haller, £45 million signing, and he was not even on the bench, and no forward in this whole team. Antonio is used as forward as expected, and these lineups are pretty much the same as I expected and predicted in my last video. As the match started, Gareth Bale, you can see on the bench, and West Ham started pretty well and they started pressing from the start, but in the first minute Harry Kane done brilliantly well to feed the ball to the young Ming Sun on the left side, and Sun does what he does best and he curls the ball past Fabianski in the opening first minute of the match. A pretty good goal, and that was pretty much expected. Kane and Sun have been involved in almost all the goals of Tottenham Hotspur this season. West Ham started creating chances and again Creswell took a free kick which narrowly missed. Then in the 7th minute, Heung-min Son fed the ball to Harry Kane on the edge of the box, and Harry Kane curled past Lucas Fabianski with a super strike, and Lucas Fabianski does not even move a single inch to stop that ball, and the ball was on the back of the net. In the 7th minute, Tottenham Hotspur were 2-0 up, and that's a lot of pressure on the West Ham defense. Harry Kane scored that goal by nutmegging Declan Rice, who is a very, very good midfielder and plays for England also. It was a super goal, and Harry Kane have been involved in a lot of goals this season. He is scoring a lot of goals, providing assists, playing like a number 10 under Jose Mourinho. On the other hand, West Ham were attacking, creating attacks, and were in front of goal for two or three times, but what they lack is that finishing touch. Mourinho is now playing as a center forward in a lot of matches under David Moyes, but he is known to be a lot of goals in front of, as his finishing has not improved much, and he takes a lot of chances and then scores some goals. And that's what is a weakness of him. Tottenham are pressing very high. They know that their West Ham defenders have lost their confidence, so they started pressing, creating attacks from all the flanks. As Sergi Reguilón in the 15th minute came charging down from the left hand side and put on a superb cross in front of Harry Kane, who headed it home between the hands of Lucas Fabianski for the third goal. Third goal in the 15th minute. Yes, that was a lot of. That was not expected according to my prediction, which was 2-1 to West Ham. That didn't happen, but at that point I thought that Gareth Bale is still to come and Tottenham can easily score 3-5 goals in this match. Jose Mourinho looking very confident about his team's performance, and that was the score line at the half time. Gareth Bale can also be seen as very delighted on the bench. The second half started and West Ham came with a plan, I think, down and attacking and pressing high in the Tottenham area. And that was the only option they had because they are 3-0 down in the first half of the match in a London Derby. That I hope that they will do well in London Derby. At that point, West Ham created chances and a chance was created, a big chance I think, that Pablo Fornals has missed was when Antonio crossed the ball and Pablo Fornals was totally free, only had to note that header into the goal, but what he had done is had it over the bar. Nothing was going West Ham's way, but they kept trying and trying and trying until the 70th minute when Gareth Bale came on for his second debut for Tottenham Hotspur, along with Harry Winks, and Ndombele was replaced with him, and Bergwijn was replaced by Gareth Bale. Before these changes, I thought that West Ham can pressurize Tottenham when they will put on their new players on the pitch, and they can score goal. But I thought that they will score one or more than one, like two goals. When the substitution happened, Gareth Bale came on and quickly took the free kick, which was stated to Lukas Fabianski. In the 71th minute, Gareth Bale came on, and after 10 minutes, in the 81st minute of the match, from Cresswell's free kick, defender Balbuena headed the ball home. And they were not pretty much confident at that time, but they thought that they will make a comeback. And that was the moment when that comeback started, and that has never happened in the Premier League before, that a team that is 80-0 down in the 80th minute and came back to draw the match. So after that goal, West Ham kept their momentum high, and quickly after 2 minutes, after Balbuena's goal, Vladimir Kofl, the new signing, has started attack from the right side and put on a cross in the box, which in Tottenham's defender Davinson Sanchez had. So that's the own goal in the 85th minute of the match, and the scoreline is 3-2, and West Ham felt very confident that they can score an equalizer late in the match. And that carried on to the 91st minute, and Gareth Bale picked up the ball and goes past one or two defenders and then shoots, but it narrowly went wide. If Gareth Bale had scored that goal, they would have put that match to the end, but that was not supposed to happen today. And on the other end, in the 94th minute, from Tottenham's poor clearance, Harry Winks put the ball in the path of incoming Manuel Lanzini. Scored a stunner, absolute stunner that I have ever seen in any match, and scoring in the 94th minute, last minute of the stoppage time, and from 25 yards out. I don't know how that went in, but the other day Hugo Lloris may have saved that, but that was not supposed to happen with a strike like that. That was distant to go in the top corner. It was a comeback completed, 3-3 on the scoreline in the 94th minute, and full time whistle was blown. And you have to look at Manu Lanzini, what it meant to him, scoring a goal in a London derby in the last minute of the match to make a comeback. That was a superb match, as expected from a London derby. That was a pretty good match, and it came according to the our expectations, as West Ham was in a very good form at the moment and grabbed 1 point from this crucial game, and now they are unbeaten against Leicester, Wolves and Tottenham Hotspur in this list. Next they will go against Manchester City and then the defending champions Liverpool. Very tough matches, but the way they are going, I think they can cause trouble to both these teams. So that was it from the last night. A very good match, and you should see its highlights also. And that Lanzini's goal, you should watch it again and again. I think it is the goal of season contender already. So that's it from today. Hopefully you will like this video, and thank you.